the complexity of like what yes was for me, it wasn't a yes towards a person, actually, right? And that's sad to say now, but it wasn't a yes towards a person. It was sort of like a yes, so I finally did this thing and happened to be with a woman. But it was more about me than it was about any sort of intimacy with the next person.
As you got older then, knowing what you know now, when you look back at that moment and that time, what might you have told yourself? What might you have said to the young lady that you had sex with?
There's a couple of things. One is that at the very least, there'd be a conversation about us and what we're about to experience. I think that at the very least. And also understand, trying to get a sense of like what she felt and what she was thinking. There was no conversation about that. And I don't think that's very different from a lot of teenage boys, sadly. But there wasn't any conversation about that. And as an adult now, that to me is, I think that's sort of disgusting as a looking back 20 years, how very sort of like disconnected from the humanity of the experience I was able to be at that time. And not even thinking about it 5 minutes after, right? At least not thinking about her 5 minutes after. So, I mean, it's 20 years later, I'm thankful I've been able to mature and grow a lot and been able to learn a lot from a lot of people who've been able to help me hold myself accountable for a lot of things. But at the time as an 18-year-old boy, thinking he was an 18-year-old man, it was a very disconnected experience.
As you grew more mature and had different experiences, what have you had to unlearn in order to have healthier encounters where there is connection? And, you know, it's interesting because when you actually break down the word consent, its actual definition means, you know, two words, con and sent, and it means feel together. So it's interesting to hear you talk about the idea of what even the other person was feeling and what you were feeling and not having that conversation. So then as you become more mature, what have you had to unlearn in terms of the models of masculinity that you were taught in order to have more engaging, connected sexual experiences?
What I have unlearned is it's not about conquering. And also that experience is about the people in it. It's not about one person. And I've had to unlearn that. You know, that people, women, you know, partners are not check boxes. I mean, that is the experience is a two-person experience. And I've had to really, it's taking time, I think, particularly because I had a certain gap. So I'm one of, you mentioned, a million men, black men, particularly, spent time in prison. So I went to prison from ages 19 to 30. So I didn't have interaction with women, at least not physically, not any physical interaction with women for over 10 years. So, like, I didn't focus. A lot of the unlearning literally sort of happened through reading certain things while I was inside, but primarily also when I was released and I'm now in the mix and interacting with people again. A lot of the unlearning kind of happened at a rapid pace. And I want to say also that it happened because there were people who I got to meet and who I got to be in community with, really close friends, brothers and sisters, that kind of like showed me different things without having, well, even explicitly telling me certain things. So that unlearning process, I want to say, is actually a lifelong unlearning process. You think that we spend most of our lives learning everything wrong about relationships and masculinity, and then we have to spend the next part of our lives unlearning a lot of that stuff. And we can't unlearn it in a vacuum. Right? We're unlearning this stuff amidst everything around us that tells us that the things that we used to think are okay. And if you're not thinking those sort of things, something's wrong with you. So we have to unlearn it despite all the pressures around us, whether it be from people that are close to us or just society in general. You know, I think about losing Virginia at 18, but I was actually raped at 14 at gunpoint. And I sometimes still kind of like subconsciously even block it out at times because of what that experience was like at that time. And, you know, as a boy and at the time feeling the homophobia and all those sort of things, kind of like drowning those sort of, not telling anybody about that experience until maybe about 8 years later, telling anybody about that experience because of how shame I felt from it. And I think like the work that I do now, a couple of things. One is that I'm much more comfortable being more vulnerable and sort of empowering, like, particularly young boys to be vulnerable about their experiences. And not only experiences with, you know, a romantic partner, but with, like, each other just in general. I think that the way masculinity works, at least toxic masculinity works, it prevents people from building authentic relationships with anybody because there's this sort of guys that, you know, masculinity means muscle. Whether it be muscle in physical form or in sort of like verbal, in the way we speak to each other. And it inhibits real authentic relationships. But the other flip side of it, in dealing with, you know, some of the work I do around gun violence prevention also, it also, masculinity or toxic notions of it are always at the seat, always at the core why so many of these like street level conflicts happen. Because folks are not able to deal with hurt and pain and vulnerability in ways that are not societally acceptable. and that's what, so me being able to like draw from past experiences, whether it be with the, you know, 18 in Virginity or speaking about, you know, the sexual assault at 14 and growing from those spaces and being able to relate lessons learned from those experiences to younger folks in a very candid and tactful way. For me, that is the work, right? Whether it be working directly in issues of sexual violence or the intersections of different sorts of violence, whether it be sexual violence, domestic violence, gun violence, other forms of community violence, like toxic masculinity that can be performed by men and women is at the core of why we have so many of these problems.